Dreaming about the things that we could be. But baby, I've been praying hard. Said no more counting dollars, we'll be counting stars. Yeah, we'll be counting stars. Like a swinging vine, swing my heart across the line. In my face is flashing signs. Seek it out and ye shall find. Old, but I'm not that old. Young, but I'm not that bold. And I don't think the world is sold. I'm just doing what we're told. Kills me, makes me feel alive.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning into WHIT Radio. We are the Freshman Radio Heads. You can see us at whitradio.org. Today we're only down to three of us in the studio here. Your host. We got Ryan Meli, and we got Shawn working boards. How you guys doing?
Good. Good.
Pretty good.
Yeah. So today we're missing Alex, Frank, and Hallie all in one day.
Well, half the class.
Exactly. But we have a good show for you. Really good stories. Interesting. Some bad, some good. Of course, we got your annual sports. You're on this day in history and everything you guys like. And all right, Shawn, let's start with you. That soldier that came back from the Taliban, right?
Yeah. A few days ago, or I forget when it was. I think it was like a week or so, or I don't know. But a little while ago, a soldier was captured in Afghanistan. It was Army Sergeant Bo Bergdahl. And he was missing for a little while. And turns out the Taliban had captured him. But today, he was returned. Today. He was returned to the army. It was a prisoner exchange with five prisoners from Guantanamo Bay that were being held there. So it's good that he was returned. You know, it stinks that that we're down five terrorists from prison, but you know, but at least we have him back.
Exactly.
I believe we have a video about this.
Yeah, they said during the search, five or six soldiers were killed, which is, wow. You know. But at least we got one soldier back. All right, well, let's put on the video. We'll see.
Breaking overnight, the first images of the actual Bo Bergdahl swap emerging on the Taliban's website. Chanting praise for their leader, 18 armed Taliban militants seen standing in wait, perched on grassy hills in the valley, guns and rocket launchers at the ready. The narration says this meeting took place at 4 in the afternoon in host province, eastern Afghanistan. At the center of the action, a silver pickup truck, Bo Bergdahl seen inside, sitting in the back seat. Bergdahl, dressed all in white, he appears to be nervous, blinking, shaky. Bergdahl seen talking with one of his alleged captors. At one point, the army sergeant even cracks what looks to be a smile while talking and then wipes his eyes. Seen flying overhead, a twin-engine plane approaching the meeting point. And then suddenly, like a scene out of the movies, the Special Forces Black Hawk helicopter descends. Two Taliban militants immediately escort Bergdahl towards the chopper, waving a white flag. Three U.S. Special Operations Commandos approach, shaking hands with the Taliban militants. They pat down Bergdahl's back and immediately begin escorting him to the helicopter. In Bergdahl's left hand, a plastic bag, the contents not yet known. The commandos wave back to the militants as they run towards the chopper. They pat Bergdahl down again, this time in a deliberate and thorough fashion, presumably a swipe for explosives right before loading him in. This face-to-face exchange lasting less than 10 seconds before they were off. A message later emerges, don't come back to Afghanistan.
All right, well, that video was courtesy of CNN, so that was good of them to put that up on the internet. You know, it's good that this guy is back. You know, he's got friends, he's got family, and he's got all that stuff. So it's good that he's back. What do you think, Jared?
Yeah, it's always nice to see a soldier coming home after, especially something bad like this happening to him. Like, you just got to think, what must he have gone through when he was captured like that, and the lengths we had to go to get him back is just, I think it's so worth it to see him come home.
Definitely. Ryan, what about you?
I think it's a great thing that he's coming back home. This should be a positive message for all soldiers everywhere. To think that your fellow U.S. Army members, Marines, Navy, whatever it is.
Anything.
Yes, to help you come back home safe and sound. Now, they did say that he did lose the ability to speak English.
He did?
Yes, while he was over there. They made him speak. What's the language they speak there?
Arabic. Arabic. I don't know how long he was captured for. Was it like a year or was it like a week?
No, I believe it was 4 years.
Oh, yeah.
4 years?
I believe.
Wow.
Wow, thank God he's back. Yeah. I've been following, you know, very, very loosely on the story. I've been hearing about it, but I haven't been paying a ton of attention to it. But 4 years, that's crazy. That's like a whole high school education
exactly.
Right there.
Exactly.
It's just, wow. But you know what? At least he gets, you know, to come back home, have somewhat of a life now, you know. But, yeah.
Yeah, that is. It's just, it's nuts. 4 years?
My God. That is crazy. Very crazy.
Thank God he's back. Pray for
him.
I'm
glad he's okay.
You know, we gotta remember all the other soldiers in Afghanistan too, all the ones that died and all the ones that have gone MIA, you know, without coming back.
They're all heroes.
So we all pray for them. They're very brave soldiers.
Freedom isn't free.
I just looked up. He was captive in there for 5 years.
5 years?
Yes.
And he forgot how to speak English?
Yeah, the parents say the recovery of Bo, who is the guy that got captured, is a work in progress. It isn't over for us in many ways. It's just a beginning for Jenny, that is his mom, and I, our family. There's a long process here, he said, referring to his wife, Bo's mother.
Wow.
Yeah, we have him up on the screen right now if you want to take a look. That's Sergeant Bo Bergdahl.
We salute him.
Yeah.
Is that when he was with the Taliban?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. So.
You know, with all this, like, movie, like when they remake things into movies, I could see in a few years this becoming a movie.
This becoming a movie, yeah. Yeah, that's possible.
Of course, yeah. Like, look at the movies like Lone Survivor.
Yeah, that was a great
movie.
That was
great, but yeah. In other news, though, just to backtrack, to go to something a little worse, a little harsh, rather. Two girls in Wisconsin, they took their best friend, they invited her over for a sleepover, and they stabbed her 19 times because of the fictional character Slenderman. They said that they wanted to worship him, and they were going to go to his apparent mansion in Wisconsin. I can't remember where they said, but
some park somewhere.
Yeah, according to CNN, it says he is Slenderman, a menacing faceless specter in a dark suit, sometimes portrayed with octopus-like tentacles, known to haunt children and those who seek to expose him. He was born in 2009 in an online forum for people who enjoy creating fake supernatural images. I know the popular game on the internet now. It's like, you know, guys, Slender. Mm-hmm. On the internet, the game. Yeah. Have you ever played it?
A lot of people.
No, I haven't played it. I've seen people play it.
Yeah, same. But that's all over YouTube. Like, you see a lot of people doing that. That was really popular. It died down now, but people still think, like, wow, this is real. No, it's just from a video game. He's a fictional character, but these girls, I guess, took it a little far.
People are crazy. They get obsessed with stuff. Of course. And they
eventually, yeah, it takes over their whole minds. Like, they're brainwashed.
Yeah, they're stepped. They went way too far with this one.
It says that they got the idea of Slenderman and the stabbing from a website called Creepypasta, which is basically
I've heard of that website.
A website that people just write fictional stories that they've created for, like, scary things. Like, they make up their own scary stories and pictures and everything and put them all into one website, and that's where they got the idea for Slenderman. And they took that, and they stabbed this girl 19 times. It said they missed very important arteries. They missed them, but they did get some organs. And the girl actually survived. And she's in stable condition in the hospital.
That's crazy. Imagine, what does it take for a 12-year-old girl to do that?
I know.
That's insane.
It's
crazy.
Just to think about stabbing someone over a fictional character.
I can't.
Just
even
to think about stabbing someone, period.
I mean, exactly.
Like, I can't even get the straw in the Capri Sun. I don't think I could stab anybody.
Exactly. But it's so weird how, like, kids, like, these are 12-year-olds, but even younger kids, sometimes they confuse reality for, like, a fictional
right. They
place.
They blur the line.
But I guess when you're young, you don't know better.
Yeah.
But, I mean, these kids were 12.
They're not that young.
Of course. Yeah, these kids were 12. I mean, they should know.
We have
they're
Slender
almost
up
teenagers.
On the screen right now.
That's a picture of Slenderman. That's him at no tentacles. He has tentacles sometimes coming out of his back. But, yeah.
Tentacles or whatever.
But, yeah, that's Slenderman. And that looks like I'm not sure if it's a picture from the game or not, but.
Yeah, well.
Yeah.
Well, whatever, it's all fictional.
Well, yeah. I will admit, if I just see that standing in the woods.
Of course, that's a little creepy.
Yeah.
But let's just hope that the girl that was stabbed is okay now and finds better friends.
that's all right.
And Ryan, back over to you. You said NASA discovered a super Earth.
No, that's not my story. I'm sorry, Jared. My story is that children on their way to get ice cream get stabbed in an elevator in New York.
Oh, yeah. But, yeah, that was a different story I had. Sorry. But, yeah, children getting stabbed in an elevator for ice cream. It's a little different from NASA's Earth story. But
yep.
What happened there?
Well, just think about it. Going down in an elevator Sunday afternoon or Sunday evening to get ice cream for a little dessert, right?
Yes.
Sounds like a good time.
Of course.
Nope, you stabbed.
Oh.
Well, New York police are searching for a man who stabbed two children, one fatality, in an elevator Sunday evening. A boy, 6 years old, and a girl, 7 years old, were both stabbed in an elevator in a Brooklyn neighborhood. The boy, whose name is Prince Joshua, nicknamed PJ, died, unfortunately. The girl is in critical condition, police say. Police are also investigating whether the attack is related to a fatal stabbing in the same area. Police described the man as a heavyset black male, approximately 6 feet tall, between the ages of 25 and 35, and last seen wearing a gray t-shirt. He stabbed a 6-year-old boy and a 7-year-old girl inside an elevator.
I saw this story.
Did they know why he stabbed them?
No. Mm. They were both stabbed in the torso. PJ was transported to the hospital as the same as the girl. And when he got to the hospital, he was pronounced dead.
And how old are these kids, you said?
The boy, PJ, was 6 years old, and the girl, whose name has not been released yet, I don't know why, is 7 years old.
Wow. Who in the right mind would stab a 6 and 7-year-old kids?
Someone's out there
deranged.
Some problem. They just, it's terrible.
Like,
I mean,
just and then and just on the other way around. I mean, I'm not sure, but why are they going out to get ice cream? You think they're a little young to go out on their own?
Yeah, walking around on their own.
They're only 6 and 7 going to get ice cream.
Yeah, I know. Where are their parents?
And where did you say this was at?
This is in New York, Brooklyn.
It's New York, Brooklyn, 6 and 7 years old, walking around to get ice cream. I don't really like that idea, but
it's lack of parenting combined with a bad environment and, you know, a deranged guy.
Of course, but I don't see how this. I don't know why anyone in their right minds would stab a 6 and 7 year old going out to get ice cream.
He's not.
They
in
just
his right mind.
They lost their I entire bet you he's lives. Not in his they right were mind. They were they weren't even living their full life yet.
Yeah,
that, right. That's just awful.
Yeah.
We did give you a detail of the subject suspect. Now, please, if you have any information on the suspect, you know, try to help.
Of course, yeah.
You can call 1-800-577-TIPS or go to the NYPD Crime Stoppers website.
Please, anything helps with those guys.
This story was brought to you by CNN.
Yeah.
And PJ's father, whose name has not been released, had walked around with PJ's book bag on his back, pretending like he was going to school, walking the route that he was going to school in.
Like retracing their steps?
Not retracing the steps, like more in honor of.
Oh. Yeah.
Because this was a Sunday evening, shame. So Monday morning he took the book bag.
The girl is still alive, though, but in
the
critical?
The girl is in critical condition in the hospital.
I saw this story. I didn't really get to read it, and, you know, it's sad.
It is sad. Very sad
That's
day
awful.
For those two.
Oh, we have a caller.
Hello, caller?
Hello?
Hello? Caller?
Hello?
Oh. All right.
Looks like they hung up.
All right, now on to weather with Jared.
Yeah. All right. Weather for today. Hold on. North Bergen, right now it is 73 degrees, beautiful, starting to feel like summer. It's always good. I mean, it is June 4th. For late future later on today, 12 p.m. is going to be 75, a little cloudy, but still sunny. Same thing at 1, it's going to be 79, cloudy. 2 p.m., 82, cloudy and sunny. 3, 82, cloudy and sunny. And then 4, it's going to be cloudy. And if you keep going, it's going to be cloudy all the way through until 11. And the temperature varies from 80 degrees to 72 degrees. And then the five-day forecast, Thursday is going to be high 72, low 57, rainy. Friday is going to be sunny and cloudy, 81-63. Saturday, sunny and cloudy, 81-63 again. Sunday, sunny completely, 82-66. Monday, T-storms, 75 and 64. That's the weather brought to you by Yahoo. Yeah. So we got a good week coming along. I mean, we need some rain. It's
yes.
been hot lately.
We can never get the weather just right. I mean,
exactly.
It's either too hot, too cold. But I think we have to comply with Mother Nature and just let
course.
Her do what she does. We have no control over her. Actually, we kind of do. Think about it.
Yeah, we do somewhat. But to fix what I said before, just a quick story. NASA discovers that mega Earth. That was my fault. I thought you were doing that.
It's all right.
Yeah, NASA, they discovered this planet. It's supposed to be Earth. It's called Kepler 10C. And it has a mass of 17 times of Earth. And it's partly since the surface and mass is made of rock, opposed to gas. The planet is 11 billion years old, but NASA's saying that there may not be life because it is very close to its parent star. And the planet is 560 light years away.
Wow.
That is very far.
Very.
Yes.
You know, just, you know, just two skips and we're there.
Yeah, I'm sure you could walk that. I mean, how long would it take to walk that distance, Sean?
Probably a couple days.
Well, you know, just
it's a few thousand lifetimes.
Yeah, you know, it's just right around the corner.
Of course. Yeah, who knows? You guys think there's life on other planets?
Yeah, there could be. Well, maybe not human life.
Yeah, of course,
maybe,
but
probably plant life.
I'm sure there's other planets, but anyway, Sean, on this day in history.
All right, well, Jared, on this day in history, we got a few different things going. We'll go from the most recent to the oldest. In 2012, the U.S. drone attacks in Pakistan killed 15 Taliban leaders, so that's definitely a good thing. In 1982, Star Trek The Wrath of Khan was released to theaters. In 1974, the Seattle Seahawks became a team in the NFL, which is a big thing with sports.
Wow.
And, yeah. And in 1845, the Mexican-American War began on this day. And going all the way back to 1039...
Wow, that's
Henry the Third became the emperor.
Jeez, Henry the Third.
Yeah. Wow, where have I heard that name before?
Back to 1039. Well, that's on this day in history. Moving on. Jared?
Yeah. All right, Ryan, you got sports going on, right?
Yes. Now here we have the finals for both the NBA and the NHL. NBA, it would be the Heat versus the Spurs. The Heat are trying to go for a four-peat championship. Game one, it's tonight, 9 p.m. Any predictions from anyone?
Nah.
I'm not really a basketball guy.
Yeah, neither am I.
Well, all I have to say about this is that the Heat, they've already gone for a three-peat. Well, will they do a four-peat?
Huh.
We'll see. Tune in tonight, game one, 9 p.m. All right, now to the NHL. Hollywood versus Broadway, East versus West, Rangers versus Kings for the Stanley Cup Finals. Now this is a big day in New York because Game 1 is tonight in LA at 8 p.m. Now this is the first time the Rangers have reached the Stanley Cup within two decades. This is a big accomplishment for them. They would sometimes get to the Eastern Conference Finals and then get eliminated by one of the other teams. This all starts tonight at 8 p.m., 5 p.m. Pacific time. Game 2 will be Saturday at 7 p.m. Game 3, Monday at 8 p.m. Game 4 will be Wednesday at 8 p.m. And if necessary, Game 5 will be on Friday, June 13th, 8 p.m. And again, if necessary, Game 6 will be on Monday, June 16th at 8 p.m., and on Wednesday, June 18th, if necessary, Game 7 at 8 p.m. Now, I would just like to say congratulations to the New York Rangers and LA Kings for making it this far, going to the finals.
Very good, very good hockey teams.
Yes, a lot of there's going to be a lot of celebrities at both games because you got the Broadway celebrities over here,
mm-hmm.
and then you got all the Hollywood celebrities back in L.A.
You always see those kind of people at the really huge games, the NBA Finals, the Super Bowl, the Stanley Cup.
Yes. And now, I will admit I did have some doubts if the Rangers were going to make it to the Stanley Cup this year at first because of how the playoffs were going, but the playoffs did work into their favor. If the Rangers would have had the versus the Boston Bruins, I would have been very nervous because the Boston Bruins are a very good team.
Yeah.
But they did get eliminated by the Montreal Canadiens. And the Rangers versus them and kicked their butt within six games.
Wow.
All right, now to baseball. We have the New York Yankees versus the Oakland. We have the New York Yankees versus Oakland yesterday. Yankees lost 5-2. And today we have New York Yankees versus Oakland again at 7:05 p.m. This game will be played at Yankee Stadium in Bronx, New York. All right, now on to the Mets. We have the Mets versus the Chicago Cubs. Yesterday they did lose that game 2-1. They will verse the Chicago Cubs again today at 8:05 p.m. in Wrigley Field, Chicago. The Mets are fourth in the Eastern Division. They are 28-30, while the Chicago Cubs are 21-34. And that is a look at your New York sports. Now back to Jared for celebrity birthdays.
Thank you. Today being June 4th, let's just go over some stars' birthdays. Angelina Jolie making her new movie, Maleficent. She is 39 today. Mackenzie Ziegler is 10 today. She was on the reality show. It's right here. Dance Moms. Has anyone ever heard of that show?
I have. My sister watches that a lot. It can get very annoying.
Yeah, she was on the season two season finale. Russell Brand turns 39. Hmm. He used to be Katy Perry's husband. Used to be.
Did he really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Molly King is 27. She's a singer. Lucas Podolski, soccer player. He's 29. Bar Rifali, sorry if I pronounced your name wrong. 29. She's a model. You guys are going to love this one. Jeremy Bieber, the father of Justin Bieber.
No one cares.
He's 39.
You can skip him.
Yeah.
We don't.
Sorry. No. We don't hate you, Jeremy. We wish you didn't follow your son.
He gave birth. All right.
Well, he didn't give birth.
No, he helped.
Yes.
So, he helped, you know what? I don't like
unless
him.
Unless it was a miracle.
Sorry.
I don't like him.
Wrong move. Noah Wyle, 43, TV actor. Going way back, 1738, 1820, George III, royalty. Brandon Jenner, he's 33. Brooke Vincent is 22. And Bradley Walsh is 54. And there's more, but I'm not going to go through all of them. Happy birthday to you all, and hope you have a good summer and stuff. And Jeremy Bieber, think about what you did. Yeah.
All right. So that is your look at your birthdays. Happy birthday to everyone.
Exactly.
And we wish you all a good day.
I'm still thinking about that. The soldier coming home from the Taliban. It's such a good thing to think about. Like, of course, it's not good that he was there, but it's good to know that he's back home and okay.
Definitely.
And I'm looking over here at CNN.com, and there's a video, and it says, did a Google camera capture a murder? Huh. Like, you know how Google Maps?
Yes. Yeah. They always
I've seen on Google Maps murder.
Yeah, there's everyone knows that one that guy killed his dog, and it was captured on Google Images.
No, I saw a guy dragging a body on Google Images.
Oh,
yeah, same.
Google Maps.
Oh, I saw the picture of him dragging his dog. He killed a dog, and it was like he was dragging it into a lake.
No, it was a guy.
I also saw a big bunny that was on Google Images.
Little things like that. Big bunny. There's like crop circles somewhere. Mm-hmm. But hold on. I'm trying to get this video to load. There's an ad, of course. Gotta love the ads. It's an advertisement for Project Open Hands. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. Let's see.
Actually, Jared, I think that's all the time we have for today.
Oh, yeah, okay.
So, thank you for tuning into WHIT Radio.
Thank you for listening.
It's been a great show. We'll see you next time.
Yeah.
See
you guys later. Thanks for listening.
Next show will be Friday.
Yeah, hopefully.
No, probably Monday.
Yeah, probably. But till next time, whatever. Just see you guys later.